सो गुड मॉर्निंग, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द बेंडिंग मोमेंट इन 3 इंच आर्चेस. नाउ इन दिस वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रॉब्लम्स. फर्स्ट यूडीएल थ्रू आउट दिस स्पैन एंड आर्च वी हैव सिमेट्री एंड देन वी आर विद टू प्रॉब्लम्स वेयर वी डू नॉट हैव आर्च सिमेट्री एंड देयर वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द रिएक्शंस एंड we are going to find out how to find maximum positive and maximum negative moment. Now we have this problem, show that bending moment at any section in the arch shown in figure is zero. Now you can see we have this as arch UDL throughout the span, symmetrical arch. L by 2 will be the span on left of hinge C and right of hinge C and H be the height of the crown. Now first we will find the reactions. So if we will go to the free body diagram, then you can see if we remove support A, then we are going to get reactions over here. So we have VA, we have HA, then we have VB and then we have HB. So we are with these four reactions, and already we have seen, though we have four reactions, we have four equilibrium equations, and therefore we are in position to find out all these reactions. Now we will take moment about B0. So what we will get, we will start VA into L. So distance between A to B is L, then minus W into L. So total load we have W into L, and that will act at center, that is L by 2. So W into L by 2 equal to 0. So from this we are going to get value of VA is equal to WL by 2. You need not require to go in these steps also. As we know it is symmetrical with center, so I can directly go VA equal to VB equal to WL by 2. That we should know. Then we have FY0 where we have VA plus VB minus W into L. So total load we have W into L. So we have W into L which is equal to 0. Now VA and VB acting upward and W into L downward. So W into L is minus, gives me value of VB equal to WL by 2. Now we have to find horizontal reaction H. So now moment about C0. So consider left part of C. So we have to consider only left part because we have seen we have to take moment about C, left also 0 and right also 0. So I have considered only left part. So WL by 2 will be the vertical reaction and HA we have to find out. So we will take moment about C0. So now what will be total load acting on this portion? So now it is not WL, it is WL by 2. Because we are considering only left part of the arch. Now where it will act? So it will act at L by 4. That is from both sides. And now we will take moment. So we have WL by 2 into L by 2 which is due to reaction. And due to load we have WL by 2 into L by 4. Now due to reaction we have clockwise plus and due to load we have minus. Now due to HA, that is horizontal thrust, horizontal reaction, we have again anti-clockwise, so minus HA into H, that will gives me value equal to 0 and that gives HA equal to WL square on 8H. Now if we will see this, we are going to get value as plus, means we have assumed towards right, so assumed direction is correct and we are going to get HA towards right. Now if we will apply FX0, then we have HA minus HB because HB we have considered towards left. So we have taken it as minus HB and that is equal to 0. And no horizontal load acts on it. So HA minus HB should be equal to 0. Now if we will substitute HA value, then we have WL square upon 8H minus HB equal to 0. Use me. HB equal to WL square upon 8H. So we have these values of HA and HB. Now we are interested actually at any section my bending moment is equal to zero. We have to show it. So we have this beam, this arch with UDL on the whole span. Now what we will do, we will consider a section at a distance x from left support. So from left support at a distance x, we have section xx. And at that x, we have vertical distance, that is y, from the base, that is from the abutments. So for parabolic arch, we know we have y is equal to 4hx upon l square into l minus x. Now we will consider only the portion that is of distance x from left support, and we are in this fashion. So you can see we have horizontal reaction WL square by 8h, we have vertical reaction WL by 2. X will be the distance we have considered where we are going to take the moment, and y will be the vertical distance from the abutments, that is from the supports. So now we will write total load, that is W into X, and where it will act? It will act at X by 2. So whenever you are going to take the moment, you have to consider the load only on left part of it or right part of it. We have to see whichever is easier. So we have total load W into X, which will act at X by 2. Now we will write equation for MXX. What is equation? So we have equation WL by 2 into X, which is due to vertical reaction. Then we have due to load, due to horizontal reaction, we have WL square upon 8H into Y. Because we have WL square by 8H, that is horizontal. So we have to take vertical distance for the moment, which is Y. And then due to load, we have again anticlockwise, so minus W into X will be the total load. And it will act at x by 2, so into x by 2, and that we have to find out. That is not equal to 0. Keep in mind, we are going to find out this value of mxx, and we have to show our value is 0 at any section. That we have to prove, so do not write equal to 0. Now we will put a value of y, that is 4hx upon l square into l minus x. So here you can see we have 4hx upon l square into l minus x, and then we have minus wx into x by 2. Now we will rearrange the terms. So l in we have l minus x in bracket, that we will separate out. So what we will get? So we have mxx wl by 2 into x. Now you can see wl square upon 8h, so that l square will get cancelled. And then 4h upon 8h, so remained is 2, that is in denominator. And we will get this value, you can see over here. So we are going to get first term as the minus WL by 2 into x. So cancel term you can see, and therefore we are going to get only WL by 2 into x. Then you can go for second term. Now we have minus x, so minus minus becomes plus. So we have plus wx square by 2, and then we have minus wx square by 2, which will be our third term, which now becomes fourth term. And in this way, if you will see, we have four terms, and out of these, two terms are similar but with opposite sign, and therefore we are going to get value of mxx equal to 0, which will shows my bending moment at any section is 0, provided my UDL is throughout the span. In your competitive exams, you may come across question on this, that bending moment at any section on a 3-inch arch loaded with UDL throughout the span is. So there we should be careful. Value is 0 at any section when we will talk about 3-inch arch. So now this is first problem. Now we will switch over to the second problem. So the equation of 3-inch parabolic arch with origin at its left support, and that equation is given x minus in bracket x square by 40. The span of the arch is given, and load 20 kN per meter over left half of the span. Determine the horizontal reaction of the support. So now you can see. So we have this 20 kN per meter. So we are going to find out VA, HA, VB, HE. HB. So arch is not given, you have to plot diagram of the arch. Now simply equation is given, by that equation we have to find out value of y at C. That means we have to find out rise of the arch. So maximum height of the arch known as rise. So we will substitute these. Now you can see we have rise of arch at x equal to 24 meter because we have total 48 meter. So we have to find out rise at 24 meter because arch is symmetrical arch. Now we will substitute the values of x equal to 24 in the given equation of y, and that will give me 24 minus 24 by 40 square by 40, and that will give us 9.6 meter. So now I know value of rise, I know loads. Now we are in position to find out the value of VA and HA. Simply we have to take first moment about B0, then we have to take moment about C0. And taking these moments, whatever we have done in last three problems, we have to go in the same fashion. Now you will see we have this one. So now I have shown these, we have shown this, that is 9.6 meters. So total load we have 24 into 20, which is equal to 480 kilonewtons. Now that will act at center, that means 12 meter from A and 12 meter from C. So we have this load at 12 meters from both sides. Now we will take moment about A0. Now why we will take in moment about A0? Because it becomes easy. Directly we can take moment of UDL as 480 into 12. Otherwise, if I will go about B, then I have to take this 12 from C plus 24 from B. So instead of this, it is better to take moment about A0. So now you can see minus VB into 48. Moment that is anti-clockwise, so minus, plus 480 into 12 because clockwise due to load, and then we have equal to 0 because horizontal reaction passes through A only, and that will give me value of VB, 120 kilonewtons. Now once I know VB, then summation FY0 gives me value of VA, VA plus VB minus 480, and that is equal to 0 because total load is 480 downward direction, and that will give me value of VA, that is VA plus 120 minus 480 equal to 0, and VA is 360 kilonewtons. Now I know now VA, I know VB, now I have to find out value of HA. Now we will consider this moment about C0. So we are going to consider again right part. Why right part? Because in left part I have to consider the load. My aim is always to reduce the calculations. So if I will consider left part, then I have to consider load. But if I will consider right part, I need not require to consider the load. And therefore we have taken moment about C0. And then you can consider we have taken only this left part. And then we have values in this fashion. And now we will take moment about C0, 120 into 24. Now see, we have considered right part. So anti-clockwise we have positive. When I am going to write down the equation moment about A0, there we are not consider left and right part. We have considered whole structure. So when you consider whole structure, then you have moment clockwise plus, anti-clockwise minus. But if you will consider left right part, then you have to be very careful with the signs. So here we have considered right part. So we have moment about C0, 120 into 24 minus HB into 9.6 equal to 0. And we have HB equal to 300 kilonewtons. So now once I know HB and value we are going to get plus, so that means whatever direction we have assumed towards left, that direction is correct. Here as value is plus means do not change the sign of the HB. HB we have assumed towards left and value is plus, means it is towards left only. Then use summation fx equal to 0 and we will get it as, therefore ha minus hb equal to 0, and therefore we have value of ha also 300 kilonewton, but it is towards right. So we have problem where we have given equation for the plotting of the arch. There we cannot go y equal to 4hx upon l square into l minus x. Now we will switch over to the next problem, and that problem we have a 3 inch parabolic arch is loaded and supported as shown in figure. Determine support reaction and maximum positive and negative bending moment. So now in first problem I have considered only concentrated load, and in the second problem I have considered UDL. Now in these problems, if you will see, my arch that is not symmetrical. So if you will see the abutments, these are not at same level. So we have for left portion rise it 8 meter, and for right portion we have it is at 4 meter. And then we have to find out the reactions first, and then maximum positive and negative bending moment. Now we will go with this. First we will draw this diagram, and here total length of the arch is given 30 meter. So now we have to first find out length of the left part of the arch and length of right part of the arch. So now we have this equation for parabola, L1 upon root H1 equal to L2 upon root H2. And if you will see figure B, then there I have mentioned that is green portion is L1 and yellowish portion we have 30 minus L1, which is mentioned as L2. Now there I am not keeping L2 because I have to convert it into one unknown only, that is L1, and therefore we have mentioned it as 30 minus L1. Now we will substitute all these values in this equation because we know H1, we know H2, unknown is L1 only, because L2 we can write in terms of L1. So now you can see this L1 by root 8 equal to 30 minus L1 by root 4. Now if you simplify it, so in simplifying, so we have cross multiplication, and that will give me root 4 L1, and that is equal to root 8 into 30 minus L1. Now you again simplify it. So if you again simplify it, then you will come across 2 L1, that is plus root 8 L1. So if you multiply by root 8 to both these terms, then we will get on right side minus root 8 L1, and that if we will take on left side becomes plus and equal to root 8 into 30. And if we will solve this for L1, then we have L1 equal to 17.57 meter. So total span is 30 meter. So automatically L2 we can get very easily 30 minus L1, and that is 30 minus 17.57, which will give me L2 equal to 12.43 meter. Now we know value of L1, we know value of L2, and now we are in position to find the reactions. Now if you remember, when we have solved these four problems in 3 inch arch, so we are going to take moment about B0, we will get one of the vertical reaction, and then above FY0 we will get another reactions. But here, as our horizontal reactions are not passing, means HA is not passing through HB and HB is not passing through HA, so we are not going to get vertical reactions directly. We are going to get two simultaneous equation in terms of VAHA or VBHB, and then we have to solve these two equations simultaneously. That will give me value of VA and HA or VB and HB. So the part is little bit different, but it's simple, no change. Equilibrium equations are same, but only we have to use simultaneous equation. Now you can see this. So we are going to take moment about B0. So now you can see we have VA, we have HA, and we are going to take moment about B0. So what we will get? VA into 30. Now this is clockwise, VA into 30. Then we have minus HA into 4. So now see distance between B and A. So we will take A below B, then we have distance between A and B is 4 meter. And moment if we will see of HA about B, that moment is anticlockwise. So we have VA into 30 minus HA into 4, and then we have moment due to 100 kilonewton. Now 100 kilonewton is at 10 meter from left, so automatically it is 20 meter from right support, and that is equal to 0. So I will get this first equation, 30 VA minus 4 HA equal to 2000, which is my equation number 1. Now we know, we will take moment about C again from left part. So you can see moment about C, that is left part. So we will consider only left part and we will take moment about C equal to 0. So that is most important which part we are considering. So now we have VA into 17.57. We are taking moment about C. So we have VA into 17.57. Then we have due to HA, which will be minus HA into 8. Now we are taking about C, and distance between A and C, that is vertical distance, is 8 meter. And so we have minus HA into 8 minus 100 into, now distance between A and C we have calculated L1 as 17.57 meter, and we have distance between A to 100 kilonewton 10 meter. So we have 17.57 minus 10, and that is equal to 0. So now we will simplify it, and by simplification we are going to get second equation. Now if we will see carefully equation 1 and equation 2, these two equations are in terms of VA and HA. Now if we solve these two equations simultaneously, then we are going to get value of VA as 76.343 kilonewtons and HA 73.23 kilonewtons. So now HA is towards right because we have considered it as right side. Now FX 0. So we have HA minus HB equal to 0 because we do not have any external load acting on it. And from this we will get value of HB 73.23 kilonewton towards left. Keep in mind this is towards left. Why? Because we have taken HB towards right, towards left, and value we are getting plus means our assumed direction is correct. Because if we will see the equation of Fx equal to 0, then we have HA minus HB equal to 0. Now you go to the Fy, and this will give me VA plus VB minus 100 equal to 0. So we have VA and VB upward, 100 downward, and that will give me value of VB, and that is 23.57 kilonewtons. So we have VA now, we have VB, and VEP will see your free body diagram, and that will get in this fashion. So we have all these values, all reactions we have calculated. Now our interest is to determine the maximum positive and maximum negative moment. Now see, as we know, concentrated load is acting in portion AC. That means obviously our maximum bending moment on left side is under the load 100 kilonewton, and right side we have to find out actually. Now we will see how we will go for this. So now we will go first for maximum bending moment. As load is acting at 10 meter from left end, so that bending moment be maximum under that load. So under 100 kilonewton we are going to get maximum bending moment. Now we will write down the equation for maximum bending moment. So what will be equation? Now you can see if we will go to the arch, then you have 76.43 into 10 and 73.23 into y, but due to vertical reaction we will get value as plus, and due to horizontal reaction we are going to get value as minus. So 76.43 into 10 minus 73.23 into y. Now we have equation of y because we have seen parabolic arch, we have 4hx upon l square in bracket l minus x. But now this equation is for symmetrical arch. So whenever we will go for this equation, we have to consider arch as symmetrical arch. Now we have arch in this fashion. We are considering left part now. So for considering left part, my arch will be symmetrical. So what I have to go? So I have to consider same arch on right side, whatever I have on left side. So now I have this arch that is symmetrical. So now what will be my value of L now? So my value of L is 2 into L1. Because L1 we have 17.57 meter. So while calculating Y, we have to consider arch as symmetrical arch. And therefore L we have to take as 2L1. And then we are in position to find out maximum bending moment. And then we can go for this. So we have y is equal to this equation. But now you can see we have considered 4HX. X is 10 meter because we have to find out under concentrated load. Now L you can see 2 into 17.57. Because we have 2 into L1. So symmetrical arch we have to consider. And into L minus X, L again we have taken 2 into 17.67 minus 10. So this part is most important while calculating bending moment in case of unsymmetrical arch. So L should be symmetrical, then only we are in position to use the equation of Y. And then from this I will get value of Y is 6.57 meter. And if I will substitute these values in the above equation of bending moment, then we will get this at 76.43 into 10 minus 73.23 into 6.57, and that is 283.18 kilonewton meter. So we have, this is maximum positive moment. So generally we have positive moment on left side and negative on right side depending upon the loads. If you have loads on right side, then becomes reverse. So now you can see maximum negative moment. Now this is most important. Now we will have this right part. Now you can see, I will plot it. So maximum negative bending moment. Now I do not have any load, nothing. We have moment due to vertical reaction, moment due to horizontal reaction. So we have moment due to V minus moment due to H. So now we have to consider where it will be maximum. So we have to use maxima and minima condition. And maxima and minima condition means we have to write down equation at xx and take derivative of that equation, equate to it 0 and get value of x, substitute x, get maximum bending moment. So maxima condition you have to use, and by using maxima condition we have to find out the value of x. So let us, we will consider a distance x from right side, and we have y distance at that x, and we will write equations. What will be equation? 23.57 into x, because we are considering right part, so clock anti-clockwise, plus minus 73.23 into y. Now we have to substitute value of y, that is 4hx upon l square. Now again we have to go for l. So what is our arch? Our arch is in this fashion. Now we are considering right part. So my arch should be symmetrical with respect to right parts. So we have to go to the symmetry with right part. And we have this symmetry with right part in this fashion. Means 12.43, 12.43. So now we have 2L2. Because bending moment we are calculating in right part. Till last we are in left part. Symmetrical with left part. So here 2 into L2, not 2 into L1. So we should be careful while taking bending moment. And then we are going to get it as maximum negative bending moment, 23.57 into, we have substituted 4. Now here H is 4. In right left part we have H8. In right part we have H4. So we have substituted, and now here I have directly substituted value 2L2 as 24.86. I have not there 2 into L2. So once we know how to take this value of length, then we can put it directly. And then we are going to get this equation, or we are going to take the derivative. Now you can see, so 23.57 derivative, we will get it as direct 23.57. Now whatever constant terms we have, that value of constant term, we will get it as 1.9. Now x we are going to take inside, so it becomes 24.8x, and second term we have x, it becomes x square. So from this we are going to get it as 24.8x86 minus x square, we have second term, which is 2x. So this value 1.9, that is value of 73.23 into 4 divided by 24.86 square. So value of these terms, we are going to get something 1.8967 likewise. So we have considered it as 1.9, and x only we have taken inside the bracket. And as we have taken x inside the bracket, we are going to get it as 24.86x minus x square, and therefore we are in the bracket 24.86 minus 2x. Now simplify it. So by simplifying, we are going to get it as 3.8x, and that 3.8x, that is equal to 47.234. And if you solve it for x, then by solving it for x, we are going to get value as 6.23 meters. And now I will substitute this value of x. 6.23 meters gives me maximum negative moment. Now for x 6.23 meter, I have to find value of y. We have substituted 4hx upon l square into l minus x, and then we are going to get y equal to 3 meters. Now substitute these values. So we have equation 23.57 into 6.23 minus 73.23 into 3, and that will give me value as minus 72.85 kilonewton meters. So that is your negative bending moment. So we have changed actually. So that we have to keep in mind. Now we are with last problem, and in this problem we have this equation. Here I have considered 45 meter span, but AC we are with UDL, that is in left part. Now here we can go, so you can see this diagram. So we are in the same fashion. So I will not again go in detail. So L1 upon root H1, in second diagram you can see we have left part L1, we have right part L2 equal to 45 minus L1. So now just substitute the values. H1 root 9, H2 root 5, and that will give me, now just see carefully, same steps we are using, no change, which will give me value of L1, which will give me value of L2. So I will just take step by step. See clearly, root 5 L1, cross multiplication we have made, then we have simplified it. And by simplifying, I will get equation 5.236 L1 equal to 135. L1 we will get 25.78 meter. So automatically L2, 45 minus 25.78 gives me value of L2, which will be 19.22 meters. So now we know L1, we know L2. So we can find reactions. Now again in the same fashion, two simultaneous equation. Moment about B0. So you can see we have taken moment about B0. So what we will get? Moment about B0. Total load we have 1289, where it will act half of 25.78 by 2. Then VA into 45. Moment we are taking about B0. So minus HA into 4. Now vertical distance between again A to B, we have 9 minus 5, 4. And then 1289 into 45 minus 12.89, because we are taking moment about B0, and as we are taking moment about B0, then we are going to get this value that is equal to 0. Now you can take moment about A0 also, but what happens when you will go moment about A0, you have to keep in mind your moment of BB and moment of HB, both are anti-clockwise, both are in the same sense, that you have to keep in mind when your arches are unsymmetrical arches. So now, so if you will solve this, so you are going to get first equation. Now we have to consider only left part, so moment about C0, so you can see here left part we have taken, and by taking this left part you can see over here, so we will take it as 25.78 VA minus 9HA, and that is equal to 1289 into 12.89, and that will give me value of VA and HA. So you can see solving two equations simultaneously, we are going to get value of VA 1013.8 kilonewton, and HA, now HA towards right because we have assumed towards right value, we got plus. Now apply FX0, so HA minus HB equal to 0, HB we have towards left, as we have assumed towards left value is plus, so it is towards left. Now FY0, so we have VA plus VB minus 50 into 25.78, that is 1289, and that will give me value of VB. Now we have all these values, you can see over here, so we have all these values, and that will be your vertical reactions. Now in my interest is towards maximum positive bending moment, negative we are in the same fashion again, whatever we have calculated in the last we have to the same step. Maximum positive bending moment, here you can see it is not under the load, here also we have to find out. Take moment at a distance x from left side, so I have considered x distance, so you can see we have x, we have y, and now we have to write down equation for distance x. So what will be equation? Mxx, so that is equal to, now 1013.8 into x minus 1057.85 y minus 50 into x square by 2. Now we have to take only that portion, that is left side portion, which is of distance x, so x by 2, so 50 into x by 2, so it becomes 50 x square by 2. Now we know why we have again 4hx upon l square into l minus x, but now again l we have to take 2 into l1 now, because we are considering left part. Now here I have again written 2 into 25.78, and we have from this, we have value of y in terms of x. And again we have to write down the equation of mxx. Now we have to go symmetrical, I have just shown you. So 2 into 25.78, y we have taken, and now we have equation. Now just see, we have substituted value of y and in terms of x, that is 1057.85. you can see this equation we have of y over here, that is most important. So here you can see value of y, x upon 73.85 in bracket 51.56 minus x, this is y, that y we are substituting in mxx, which is equation we have written above. In that equation we are substituting value of y, and that I have substituted over here, that is x upon 73.85 51.56 minus x, minus 50x square, and then you can simplify it, and I will get it as mxx as, and now we will go for derivative. So by derivative we are going to get value of x, 275.24 minus 21.36, and that will give x 12.89 meter. So knowing value of x 12.89 meter, we can find mxx by just substituting mxx. We have 75.24x minus 10.68x square. In that equation of mxx, we can directly substitute x, gives me value of mxx. So we have variety, you can find y, substitute in equation, basic equation of mxx, or you can put in the equation which is just before the derivative, and that will gives you mxx value. Now myy, I will go little bit fast because that already is same whichever we have considered in the last example. So again consider section 275 vertical reaction minus 105.57.85y, then make it symmetrical. So you have 2 into L2, now put equation of mxx, so put value of y 4hx upon L square. Now here L is 19.22 into 2, 38.44, because we have to consider symmetrical arch. Then take dmxx upon dx0, so I have directly taken instead of simplifying it, and gives me value of x 9.61 meters. Now knowing all these values, we are in position to find out value of y. So I have substituted, find a calculated value of y 3.75, and substituted in basic equation of x, and that will give me minus because we have negative moment on the left hand side. So problem, whatever problem, that is bending moment in symmetrical, unsymmetrical, positive, negative, we should be in position to find out it. So we will stop here only today. So this is all about your bending moment.